think all this luck.
I'm sorry. I don't know. I was supposed to be here 3 hours ago. I'm sorry.
Right, let's go.
I'm so sorry.
Miss, wait. The permit expired about an hour ago. The police are going to be by here any minute.
No. You have to call them. Here.
30 minutes, maybe. I also know some people at the phone company if you want service by the end of the week. Otherwise, who knows?
Phone on by noon. Table by the end of the week, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah, the city's dirty. The place feels cramped. And for $3,000 a month in Seattle, we'd be on a waterfront acre. But I'm open.
The phone's working?
Our first call. It's your sister. She says we're listed.
Oh. Hey, Maggie.
Yeah, we're in moving hell. I gotta go. I'll call you back later. Okay. Come here.
What?
Come here.
Let me show you. What's that?
Take a look at this. $3,000 a month on Central Park West? This is a steal.
Steph, the bottom line is this is an incredible opportunity for you.
Hey. It's going to be great for you, too. Just think of all the wonderful writers that this city's produced. You're going to fit right in.
And yeah, there's even a cappuccino bar around the corner, so it's not that big a sacrifice.
Mm. Can't wait to break in the joint.
Well, with this view, we can flash the whole city, baby.
Okay, I got to go. I've got my first staff meeting in an hour. Can you hold down the fort?
You got it.
Okay. Hope they like me.
The precedent they're referring to doesn't meet the criteria of this case. There are special circumstances here that completely change the landscape and render all the financial records they're so desperate to withhold as completely admissible.
Peter, listen to me. You know and I know that you're in this job because you're good and because I like you. But I really hated that crap in the Daily News the other morning. We're working on some very delicate cases, and the last thing we need is publicity.
Believe me, I'm more upset about it than you are.
Now some reporter from the Globe is calling, wanted to verify reports of women in the jury swooning during your opening remarks.
That's ridiculous. I haven't even gone to trial yet.
And if you're still together with a model you're dating?
Which one? I mean, there's no one serious in my life at the moment.
Peter, you're very bright, but I can't have some damn rock star trying cases for me, even if he is a Fairchild.
What do you want me to do, change my name?
No, just keep it out of the press.
Peter, your brother.
Oh, hi, sweetheart. I'm sorry, they've been hassling me all morning from the magazine. Alan's installed a new editor. She has everybody in a complete panic.
Have you met her yet?
I will. Eventually. Anyway, I know where you're calling, Peter. You're trying to get out of Mother's lung cancer ball. Well, you can forget it. I'm not facing the family without you.
No, I'll be there. I don't have the guts not to show. Carrie, I'm calling because someone at the Globe might be doing a story on me.
Oh, congratulations.
No, it's not like that. You see, they're trying to undermine my credibility. So if someone does get a hold of you, just say no comment.
Whatever you say.
Carrie, are you smoking?
No. I told you I quit last month.
Great. Listen, I gotta run. See you tonight.
I'm counting the minutes.
So you taking me to this party?
I haven't decided if I'm going out with you again. Man.
mandate, if you will, is not to completely overhaul Communique, but to blow out the cobwebs and broaden our reach while we chart a course for the next decade, from sex to health to fashion and entertainment. We've got to focus our pieces so that they're relevant and provocative to a new generation of readers and advertisers. I'm sorry, there's no smoking in here.
Since when?
I'm allergic.
Pardon me?
Most of all, I want this to be a magazine that all of us are proud to be associated with. One that both men and women will read in order to understand their world and each other a little bit better. Any questions?
I'm sorry, I didn't catch your qualifications.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
Carrie.
Well, Carrie, if you'd been here an hour ago when the meeting started, you would know that I'm from Seattle, where I published Body Magazine and grew it into the number one fitness publication in the country.
Sounds exhausting.
If you'll forgive me, Carrie, I'm not exactly sure what you do here at the magazine.
I provide a particular jaded feminine perspective. It's a downtown nightlife column. Unless, of course, I've just been bumped by a tighten your tummy routine.
As I said before, nobody's losing their job or their columns. And in the future, Carrie, do me the favor of showing up to staff meetings on time. There's nothing I hate more than repeating myself. Understood?
Perfectly.
Good. Great. Why don't we all take a lunch break? I'll be in my office if anyone needs me. Carrie, may I see you for a moment, please? Sure. I'm sorry. I think we somehow got off on the wrong foot.
No problem.
Sit down. There's something I'd like to talk to you about. Part of the reason that Alan Rush hired me is because I have a pretty good reputation for running a tight ship. I also have a talent for squeezing a dollar. And if I can do nothing else but bring production costs down around here, I'll consider it a job well done.
Your point?
Evaluating the budget, I realized that you happen to be the highest paid writer at the magazine. $200,000 a year for a few poorly written column inches. That's obscene.
For your information, Alan Rush is my stepfather.
I know. And I'm your boss. So my suggestion is, if you want to keep that cushy little paycheck of yours, at least let it pay for a few weeks of charm school.
Listen, Steph. Here are the ground rules. I do what I like, where I like, when I like. Don't question my expense reports. Don't expect me to show up for staff meetings. My column gets published every month as written. The rest of the magazine is your domain.
I don't know what kind of pushovers you're used to dealing with, Carrie. But as long as I'm sitting in this chair, the only ground rules at the magazine are going to be set by me.
Well, enjoy the delusion of power while it lasts. Because when reality hits, it can be a real bitch.
To the newest toast of Manhattan.
As long as you think so.
So, who can I be devastatingly charming to on your behalf?
All we have to do is say hello to my boss and his wife, and we're free.
That's it?
That's it.
It's much too small a price to pay for such good champagne.
Well, you did have to rent that tux.
True.
Here we go.
Very generous.
Alan.
Stephanie. Nice to see you. This is my wife, Linda. Darling, this is Stephanie Wells, my new editor of Communique.
Glad to meet you. Nice to meet you. My husband, Mark Merrill.
Nice to meet you both.
All right.
Alan, I want to thank you for arranging that job for me at East Side Prep.
Anything. To finally get Stephanie here. Tell me, how was the first day?
Wonderful. Really. You have a terrific staff.
You know, your late husband was such an inspiration to me growing up.
Really? I'm very pleased to hear that.
I'm sure you must often wonder what this country would have been like had he actually lived to serve out his term in Congress.
I don't indulge myself in that painful speculation. Excuse me, would you?
Of course, I'll just grab myself another drink.
You're completely identifiable by scent alone, Nikki.
I'll take that as a compliment, Mr. Fairchild.
You better.
So how have you been, Peter? Ever since you started that new job, you never write, you never call.
Things have been hectic.
Well, at least you could just pop by the gallery and take me out to lunch. People that promise to stay friends do that sort of thing.
I will. I promise. So, who roped you into this?
Your benevolent sister volunteered a painting from my gallery for the silent auction. It's probably hanging in some godforsaken corner someplace.
I'd love to help you look, but I've got to find my family. We're playing softball tomorrow in the park, 6 o'clock. Be there?
Maybe. Cheap multimillionaire bastards. People come to these so-called charity events and then they try to steal the art for nothing. Well, they can forget about it. I'm not letting it go for twice the price.
Are you the artist?
No. I donated it from my gallery. Nikki Sheridan.
Mark. Mark Merrill.
Go ahead. Bid high.
Oh, God. Sorry. I'm just the poor, struggling writer bastard.
Really? Anything I've...
Doubtful. One book. 5,000 copies. Great reviews, but nobody read it.
You were published. That's impressive. What's it called?
Bright Heaven.
I like the title.
Thanks.
So what brings a poor, struggling writer like yourself to such a chic gala evening?
My wife. We just moved here from Seattle. She's the new editor of Communique, and evidently Alan Rush is...
The Darth Vader of publishing. No, don't worry. He takes that as a compliment. I know I'm a friend of the family's.
Really?
I wish your wife luck. May the force be with her. And then some.
In case you've forgotten, this ball is in honor of your father, who was cut down in his prime by lung cancer.
Just think of me as carrying the torch.
You live to mock me. That's pathetic, Carrie.
What is going on?
Nothing.
Personally, I'm trying to recover from the thrashing I got at work today. That new editor you hired is a piece of work. She threatened me.
Oh, I seriously doubt that.
She said she's cutting corners, starting with my salary. I admit it's a bit too high. But considering you're too cheap to give your stepchildren any money, I have to earn every dime
Carrie,
I can.
Carrie, that's enough.
Hi, all. Sorry I'm late.
Why don't you look at your brother as an example? Here's a man who's worked for every success he's achieved in life, and he's going to go on to great things because of it. You watch.
Sorry, have I interrupted something here?
No.
No, I was just saying goodbye.
Carrie!
For God's sake, Linda, let her go.
Peter, please talk to her.
All right, I will.
I have to talk to Maud. Excuse me.
Carrie, come on. Let's try to get along, at least for just one night.
It's tough not being the golden child.
Come here.
You're the only one I love. You know that, don't you? I gotta get out of here.
Excuse me for a second, will you? Thank you.
Excuse me.
I hear you met my stepdaughter this morning.
Yes. We didn't exactly get off to the best start, but I want you to know that I'm going to work really hard to make sure that she's happy.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about. You see, while I despise nepotism, my wife insists that Carrie work at the magazine.
I understand. Kid gloves.
No. Brass knuckles. I've had it with that little bitch. Make her miserable. See that she quits. Otherwise, you may be the one standing on the unemployment line.
emailed Deanne last night. Told it was over.
In a nice way.
She broke up with her over the internet.
It's clean. It's clean as having a message on her answering machine she can play over and over. I don't want my voice being held hostage.
I thought you liked Deanne. She invested all that money with you.
Yeah, you know, she's all right, but she's too brainy. You'd never date a girl that brainy.
You're wrong, pal. My priorities have shifted. Intelligence, sense of humor, they're at the top of my
list.
Yeah,
right below staggeringly gorgeous. You know, there's not a woman in the city who's not desperate to go out with you. You could be 3 feet tall and Fairchild Man would still sell tickets.
Right now, it's my name that's almost costing me my job. There was this item in the Daily News yesterday insinuating that the only reason I'm working in the DA's office is because 10 years ago, he campaigned for my father.
That's a lot of crap.
No, I learned at Harvard that no matter what I accomplish, ultimately my dad's going to get credit for it, which might not piss me off quite as much if he were still alive.
You know what your problem is? You're so damn good, but you make it look too easy. You gotta learn to show a little sweat.
Hey, watch out!
Whoa, whoa!
Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry, it's my first day in these things.
No problem. Just try to avoid heavy traffic.
Thanks. I'll do my best.
Hey, we play softball today at 6 sharp. Field Ooh. Number 3. 100 bucks you don't show.
Real smooth.
I'd love to see it, but if it's going to the museum, then let's not waste our time. Okay. Okay. Call me when you hear something. Wow, you have some nerve showing your face here. What happened to you last night?
I'm sorry. I got a bad case of altitude sickness. My nose starts to bleed above 14th Street. Come on, I want to take you to lunch. I got a table waiting at SoHo Kitchen. Let's go.
I heard Alan hired a new editor.
Yeah, Stephanie Wells. Just started yesterday, and already she's trying to turn me into a little worker bee. Trust me, she's not up to the fight.
I met her husband last night.
You did? What's he like?
Cute.
How cute?
Very. Said he was a writer, wrote one book or something.
What's it called?
I don't remember.
Nikki, it was just last night.
He said it received good reviews, but nobody read it. Something about heaven. Bright heaven.
Bright heaven. You go ahead, Nikki. I just realized I've been doing this all wrong. I should be giving Stephanie the support she needs. Kill her with kindness, you know what I mean?
Where's all of this coming from?
Talking to you. You put things in perspective. I'm gonna go. I don't want to be late for our afternoon staff meeting.
Hey, what about lunch?
Save the check. It's on me.
We're supposed to get some employment indicators tomorrow, but I'd advise you to buy now. At least 100 grand if you'd like to put a dent in this thing.
This issue has been outperforming the market by 20%. Right. I think it's got long-term potential, though there's bound to be a correction.
No, I'm not pressuring you, sir. I'm just suggesting.
Yeah, sure, I can hold it.
No, I'd be happy to.
It's up or stock.
You gutless bastard. Do you have any idea what you've done to me?
Deanne, this is not the place. I'm talking to a client.
Look, you ruined me, and you didn't even have the decency to pick up the phone.
Deanne, I am sorry. Something like this, it's never happened to me before, okay? I freaked out, too.
I trusted you, Gil. I really trusted you.
I know.
I gave you all of my money. Everything from my parents' estate, all of my security. You understand? Everything.
It was a bad break, Deanne. I've never seen stock go south like that in my entire life.
Why wasn't I diversified?
You were. And then I got this tip. I thought it was a great opportunity.
But it went south.
Yeah, it went south.
And on top of that, you're dumping me? What kind of scum are you?
You know, Deanne, for the past 3 months, all you've done is judge my sexual performance, my emotional availability, my intellectual shortcomings. Now here you are berating me for a bad stock. Newsflash, I don't control the market. I make educated guesstimates.
Gil, your lousy guesstimate lost me over $100,000. And excuse me, but I was never judging your sexual performance. I don't do that sort of thing.
Can you talk about this later, please?
No, we are through talking. But don't think I am just going to dry up and blow away. I am going to get you for this, Gil.
Prep is one of the most revered and established learning institutions in Manhattan. We produce more National Merit Scholars than any school in the country, while almost 90% of our students go on to an Ivy League college.
What happens to the other 10%? Suicide? Sorry, it was just a joke.
Mr. Merrill, we weren't planning to take on any new instructors this year, but given that Mr. Rush is one of our most enthusiastic supporters, we have managed to squeeze you in.
Thank you, but I prefer to be here on my own merits. I hope you know that I have been teaching writing for a number of years at an excellent small college outside of Seattle.
Yes, we are aware of that. We are also aware of a complaint filed by one of your female students.
Excuse me?
I only say this because this school has never been touched by scandal, and we can't afford to have our good standing impaired by...
Miss Phillips, I know you think you're doing someone a favor by giving me a job here. But the truth is, you'll be damn lucky if I decide to teach here. And if I do, I trust that my good standing won't be impaired by unsubstantiated gossip. Thanks for your time.
Peter.
Alex.
This is Nikki.
Nice to meet you, Alex.
Gil Chase.
Come on, let's play, huh?
Gil, you're up. Hey, you want to go get a drink? It's getting dark, and thanks to you, the game's basically over.
Let's go.
Game's over. We're just going to go get a drink.
Strike three!
Life just happens to suck at the moment.
Tell me.
I don't think I'm going to take that job.
Why not?
Because they don't want to hire me. I'm being shoved down their throats courtesy of your boss.
Hey, you can't look at it that way. They'd be lucky to have you. They'll realize it once you start.
They knew all about the thing at Mount Wilson. You know, I shouldn't be teaching anyway. No, by this point, I should be supporting myself writing. I should be supporting us.
If you don't want the job, don't take it. I made you move here, and I'm making enough money for both of us right now.
Let's get one thing straight, okay? I'm here because I want to be here.
Good. I just want us both to be happy.
You've got to deliver a performance, please an audience, but when the show's over, there's actually something at stake.
I would hate the responsibility. Somebody's fate depending on me.
I'm used to it. Responsibility was pretty much thrust on me at an early age.
So what happens if you're wrong and you end up sending some completely innocent person to the chair?
Well, it doesn't happen like that. Most, if not all, of the people I prosecute are guilty.
Oh, come on. That's a completely elitist assumption.
No, what?
Did you ever stop to think that maybe you're just so incredibly persuasive with your stalwart manner and your chiseled Viking jaw that you're convincing juries to put otherwise completely innocent individuals behind bars?
It's ridiculous. Number one, I don't have a chiseled Viking jaw.
How would you describe it?
You know, I'd much rather talk about how beautiful you are.
Come here. Girl, my mother used to take me over on the ferry to see the Nutcracker.
Well, the ferry from where?
Staten Island. I'm sure you've heard of it. I'm also sure you've never been there.
Come on. Give me a break. Did you ever dance?
Yeah. Like all little girls, I harbored vague fantasies, but then I grew up and realized it's not something you become. It's something you're born to. Plus, we didn't have the money for ballet lessons. Major handicap.
So what do you do now?
For a living.
Yeah.
I work at the cosmetics counter at Bergdorf's.
Guess that explains why you have such soft skin.
Stop by someday. I got just the thing for those dry lips. See you around, kiddo.
Hey, wait up. I'll walk you home.
No, I gotta meet a friend for dinner. Take care of yourself, Peter.
Who is, Deanne Landers?
Girl likes to date.
And a client?
That's right.
She's suing us for abuse of fiduciary responsibility. Says you coerced her into poor investments without sufficiently explaining the risks involved.
Seemed like good bets at the time.
Please, God, do not let me discover you have an acquaintance who happens to own this crappy little computer company and you...
No, Jared, it's nothing like that. As a matter of fact, Peter Fairchild...
No, Gil, I'm tired of hearing about all these fancy friends of yours. Unless, of course, they're actually going to start investing some money with this firm.
You know, this thing with Deanne is nothing but a personal matter. I'm sorry her scare tactics got to you.
Fairchild.
Peter, it's Carrie.
Before noon? What are you doing up so early?
I'm at work. I've decided to be good. You know, toe the line and all that.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, listen, I'm throwing a little party for my new boss tonight at the vault. I want you to come.
Carrie, you know I can't keep up those vampire hours anymore.
Come on, everyone's gonna be there. Gil, Nikki. Oh, and bring that new girl you're seeing, the one you met at the softball game yesterday.
God, there are spies everywhere.
Don't be so paranoid. And don't bother showing up before 11.
Peter Fairchild?
Yeah.
Paulina's at 8, and don't forget to moisturize.
Thank you for coming. I wasn't sure if you would.
No, I think you were pretty confident I'd be here.
I didn't mean to run off like that last night. I was feeling myself so attracted to you. But then the name and the image of who you are got in the way, and I thought, this is stupid. We have nothing in common. I'm from an Italian working-class family, and you're a Fairchild.
You make it sound like there's horrible stigma.
Is it?
Sometimes.
How?
People are always judging you. They have these crazy expectations that you can never fulfill. And no matter what I accomplish, it never seems to be enough. It never can be enough.
Come on, you're young. You've got this great job in the DA's office.
I know, and I'm assisting on some of the highest profile cases in the city. I mean, we're going after some people in the mayor's office who've been untouchable for years.
Really? Like who?
It doesn't matter. The point is, I'll never be my father. And when you get right down to it, that's all anyone ever wants me to be.
I know how you feel. My mother passed away a few years ago, and I got five brothers who, along with my father, have depended on this woman's cooking their entire lives. Myself, I can't even boil pasta, so I'm this huge disappointment to them, because it was up to me to learn all the recipes.
You've got to come over to my place for dinner. I'm a great cook.
You see? Men can cook. That's what I tell my brothers.
Bon appetit.
What are you trying to do, kill us here? Look, all families have their stuff. Yours, I guess, is just on a different scale. What?
I like you. That's all.
Yeah. I like you, too.
Just you in a photograph, see?
Picture?
Started at the magazine, I feel like I'm tiptoeing through a family minefield. I mean, first this Carrie Fairchild treats me like I'm the hired help, and now she's making nice and throwing me a party. I'm not buying it. Stephanie Wells? Hey.
Suing me over is the fact that I dumped her. She's using that stock thing as an excuse.
Great tonight. I'll meet you upstairs.
Do you know what you are, Gil? You're a toxic bachelor.
What's that supposed to mean?
You lead women on. You become their best friend, tell them what they want to hear, and then anywhere between 3 weeks and 3 months, that is whenever the sexual fireworks die down, you end it.
Yeah, it's not quite that simple, Nikki.
Yes, it is. And given the fact there are about 1,000 women for every single straight man in this city, you keep getting away with it.
Excuse me, but did I ask to be psychoanalyzed this evening?
Hello? Stephanie, I'd like to introduce you to my closest friend, Nikki Sheridan. She owns
Hi.
A fabulous gallery in SoHo. Gil Chase, one of my brother's friends.
Hello.
Hi. Have you seen Peter? I'll kill him if he doesn't show.
I haven't seen him.
Nikki, could you introduce Stephanie to Isaac Mizrahi? I think he's hiding in the corner.
My pleasure.
Thanks. Hi.
Hey, hi.
Hold this.
Right.
Carrie Fairchild.
Oh, hey, it's nice to meet you.
I recognized you from your book jacket.
Don't tell me you actually read my book.
Of course, I'm a tremendous fan. When I found out that Stephanie was married to Mark Merrill, I couldn't believe it. How did she ever persuade you to leave Seattle?
It wasn't easy, but this is too good an opportunity for her to pass up.
Bright Heaven is without a doubt the most brilliant piece of fiction I've read in years. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Well, thank you, really.
you like surprises?
Well, I guess that depends.
I have a fabulous one planned for you and Stephanie. She has a lot of people she needs to talk to. I'd hate to tear her away. You afraid of heights?
Not generally, no.
Good. We'll be back before anyone misses us.
Why not?
Come on.
Maybe I've been in love once in my life. Maybe twice. The second might have been infatuation.
What about the first?
He left me and married my best friend, Myra Carpazi.
You know, I think I saw the three of you on the Ricky Lake show.
We could have been. Especially since Myra had the nerve to ask me to be her maid of honor.
Listen, I'm supposed to drop by a party my sister's throwing at this club downtown.
I don't know. I'm really not much for those kind of places. I can catch a cab home if you want to go. No
hey,
problem.
Why do you always keep trying to run away from me every chance you get?
I'm not. It's just that I'm not into the club scene, that's all.
Fine. I'll call your cab. Alex! Once around the park.
Yes, sir.
I've never been in one of these before. It's wonderful.
It makes you dream about what this city might have looked like 100 years ago.
So what about you, Peter? Have you ever been in love?
You know, I'm not sure that I ever have.
Come on, Steph. We looked for you. All I could think about the entire time is how much you would have loved the view.
You're right. I'm beginning to think that last night was just a flimsy excuse for Carrie to get you alone.
Don't tell me you're jealous.
No. But I think that Alan may have a point. I think it should be my top priority to get Carrie off the magazine.
Give the kid a break. She's actually very sweet.
Since when did you become such a lousy judge of character?
Maybe I'm just a bit partial to fans of my book.
She read your book?
Well, don't sound so shocked, Steph. There are some people who actually did read it.
Hey, I'm sorry. You know that's not what I meant. Look, why don't we go someplace wonderful for dinner tonight? Just you and me.
Yeah?
I feel like we haven't spent 5 minutes together since we moved here.
Name the place.
I have to call you from work. Will you be here?
Working on my play. Starting to feel like I finally have a shot at getting it produced.
I have no doubt.
News is good. Your girlfriend's lawyers pushed for a settlement, obviously sensing they don't have a case. We threatened a countersuit and basically sent them running with their tail between the legs.
So that's it?
Yeah, that's it. But next time, err on the conservative side when you invest for friends and family.
Absolutely. And thanks, Jer. I'm really sorry about any trouble this caused.
Looking for Alex Bartoli?
Oh, hi. Who is it that you wanted?
Alex Bartoli. She works here?
I don't think so, but maybe she's at our men's store. Would you like me to check?
Please.
I'm sorry. Nobody by that name works at Bergdorf's.
I see. Well, and these are for you.
Wow. Thank you.
I love it. I really love it.
I can't believe he got all this.
He talked nonstop for hours. Told me everything about his father, the pressures of being a Fairchild, his job at the DA's office, which, by the way, looks like he got on his own merit.
Yeah, don't let him fool you. These people don't work for anything. They're given everything. Is that a picture?
Yeah.
Well, let's see it. Come on.
That photographer cost me $200 out of pocket. Don't give me any grief about it. He's actually a really nice guy. Very genuine, sincere.
Uh-huh.
Great sense of humor. Kind, romantic. The truth is, you don't find many guys like that in the city, no matter who they are.
We'll make sure we lose all that stuff when we run the piece. My date with Peter Fairchild. It's great work, Alex. You're looking as Sunday's front page.
John, you know, I...
Yeah.
Never mind.
Just a minute.
Hey.
Come in.
Sorry, is this a bad time?
Oh, no, no, no. Just running behind a little bit this afternoon. Want a drink?
Sure. Quick one, but then I really gotta get going.
Is that the masterpiece?
Well, why don't you read it first and let me know?
I'll be right back.
Champagne?
Not allergic, are you?
No.
You know, Mark, I have a theory about you.
Well, let's hear it.
I think you underrate yourself. Being married to a powerful woman can do that. You're so accustomed to living in her shadow, you forget you cast one of your own.
I heard everyone in Manhattan was in analysis, but I didn't know they all moonlighted as shrinks.
All I meant was, you're very charismatic. The fact that you seem to be unaware of it makes you all the more charming.
The charm. The quality you appear to have mastered.
How wonderful to have found something in common.
I appreciate whatever you can do. Now, I really have to get going.
I'll let you out.
Yeah.
And even nicer to have made a new friend.
Just what my secret is, and I'll just leave it at that.